Mr. Giroux, to further our understanding of finding limits of functions that we've just been learning about finding graphically and numerically and eventually with properties, we understand that for limits to exist, we have to have both the left limit and the right limit be equal. They have to be approaching the same y value from both sides. So we're going to use this information to develop some sketches, some possible sketches of what some functions, we're not going to be graphing relations, might look like based on some information. And we're going to do four of these. So we have here the limit as x approaches 3 of some function f of x is equal to 2. Well, I don't have a little marker up here in the top right-hand corner, or an exponent, if you will, of negative or positive. So I'm not talking about a left limit and a right limit, but a two-sided limit, which is equal to 2. Well, we know now that for a two-sided limit to exist, both the left and the right limit must be equal. The function must be approaching the same y value from both sides. So based on that information, we have as x approaches 3, the function has a limit of 2. Now that doesn't mean that necessarily the function is equal to 2 at 3, but the function is going to approach a value of 2 from both the left and right side. So, you know, there's some kind of dot, and I don't know if it's going to be open or closed, but the function is approaching the same y value of 2 from both sides. And I don't know, you know, maybe this is what the function looks like, and it's some kind of cubic. So that's what's happening with this piece of information right here. Okay. Well, now it says the domain is going from negative infinity to positive infinity. So the domain is all real numbers. So the function is going to be defined for every value within the domain. Okay? So that means that if I leave a hole here, then this function would be undefined at the value of 3. So I'm thinking that we're probably going to have a closed dot there at the value of 3, 2. So the function's value is probably going to be equal to, the value of 2, or value of 2 at the x value of 3, but I'm going to leave that open just in case we need to leave it that way. Let's find out what more is going on. And the range of the function goes from negative infinity up to, and actually including, 2. So just based on this information alone, looks like we have here, let's see, well, I can't have the function going above the y value of 2 because that's the maximum value of the range. So the range the y values go from negative infinity up to 2. So from the left, we're coming from negative infinity and we're approaching, there wouldn't really be an arrow there, but I'm just trying to teach, but we're approaching that value from the left side of 3, we're approaching that limit of 2. And I don't know where the x-intercept is. I don't have any information about x-intercepts, just the limits and domain and range. And again, that two-sided limit is equal to 2, so we're going to be approaching from negative infinity up to 2. Now, it says here the range is from negative infinity and includes the value of 2. So I have to actually have the graph. If I put a hole there at the value of 3, 2, then the function is just going up and approaching that open dot from the bottom, okay? Can't be approaching from the top because then my range would be greater than 2. So if I leave it drawn like this with an open dot, my range goes all the way up to 1.9999, but not exactly equaling the whole value of 2. So I'm going to go ahead and close in that dot, and it looks like, and this is only one possible diagram of what this function might look like. I mean, it could be a V-shape. You know, as long as I draw a sketch that has a two-sided limit, which is equal to 2, a domain that includes all real numbers, and a range that goes from negative infinity and up to 2. Now, I said I was going to do four examples, but let me just change this a little bit. What if I wanted to have the range go from negative infinity up to the value of 2, but not include it? Well, then I would have to indicate that there is a hole here at the value of 3, 2. So we still have a limit. The function still has a limit of 2 as you approach the y value as x approaches 3. But if I let this be my function, and I kind of have it confusing here with two functions at once, I'll just kind of focus on the parabola. So this parabola, if you will, opening down, or at least it appears to be a parabola, has that left and right limit both equal to 2, so that's satisfied. Has a range which goes from negative infinity up to 2. But it says here the domain is all real numbers, and my domain, my function here so far, has a domain from negative infinity to 2, and then from 2 to positive infinity. So I'm not meeting this requirement of the domain being all real numbers. So I can just come in here somewhere, and I can't close in the dot here because that would show that the y value of 2 is included. And with my adjusted problem, it's not. So I'm just going to, put a solid dot there. Have some kind of basically a piecewise function that has just a dot, which we're going to learn. By the way, if you have a hole in your function, we're going to learn that's called a removable discontinuity. And I've got that dot here at the value of 3, 0. So I have the function defined at the value of 3 and everywhere else. And thus I have actually two examples there I just did. So I guess I'm doing 5. Next example, limit as x approaches negative 2, two-sided limit, of f of x is equal to 5. Domain, again, all real numbers, negative infinity to positive infinity. And the range, though, is actually now, is it looks like it's almost all real numbers, and actually another way of writing this range would be, well, negative infinity to 5, and from 5 to positive infinity. The only thing I've left out is that y cannot equal 5. That's another way, an inequality way, if you will, of writing this range. So let's see. Okay, the two-sided limit is equal to 5, so we have to be approaching 5 from both the left and the right, whether it's like this, or whether it's like this, or whether it's coming up from the bottom like the previous one, and it's approaching the same y value of 5 from both sides. But I don't think it's going to be... Well, there's all kinds of different things we can draw. I think one version, let's just say here we got the x value of negative 2, 5. So negative 2 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so something is going on here. Now if I draw a function that, approaches this way and maybe drops down again, that function would have a two-sided limit approaching from the left and the right of 5, but I don't want to make this look exactly like the last one. I could also have it, go up from that value and approach as you approach from the left. We're still approaching that y value of 5, but from the bottom, maybe like 4.8, 4.9, 4.99, 4.999. And then from the right, coming down from above the 5, coming down to 5.5, 5.1, 5.01, and so on. Okay, so that would satisfy this limit as x approaches negative 2 of it being 5. And if I draw it this way, I could actually have it come down, okay? But if I had it come down and then maybe swing back up again, because it has to, because we have a range now that goes from positive 5 and above, then I would have to include another hole so that I don't include that y value of 5. Oh, I'll turn that arrow off in a second. Sorry about that. We have a domain of all real numbers, and actually, from what I have here, I have a function that has my domain is all real numbers except x cannot equal 2, so I'll have to fix that in a second. It goes down to negative infinity and up to positive infinity, and the y value of 5 is not included because of the hole, and we are approaching the y value of 5 from both the left and the right of negative 2. So, really, again, here to satisfy the fact the domain is all real numbers from negative infinity to positive infinity, I just need to put a dot somewhere. Let's say here. That has an x value. It's using the x value of negative 2. Now my function is defined for all real values. I have a range that basically excludes the y value of 5, and my two-sided limit is 5. Next example. I just turned around, and I shouldn't be confusing you with leaving a couple of sketches up here. If I did sort of drop this graph down and come up here and create another hole to skip that y value of 5, I would have to put another dot vertically somewhere to fill in, whatever the x value is that I had to open that hole up. So let's go ahead and, not to come up with another example, though there could be many versions, many answers to this particular solution, let's just leave one up there. Actually, I apologize. You are going to have to deal with the air conditioner noise. I don't have the time to let the house cool down before turning that off, so it's a little bit quieter in the video. Hopefully it's not too distracting. Okay, now, there's, you know, when you find limits, there's actually finding real limits, and then there's finding infinite limits. And actually even stating that an infinite limit exists, what you're actually stating when, like say here, the limit as x approaches 1, there's no little negative or positive, so we're talking about a two-sided limit, of f of x is equal to negative infinity. That means that as you approach negative 1 from the left and the right, the function's y value is approaching negative infinity, which is not a real value. It's actually, you know, like a theoretical value. It just keeps going and going and going and becoming infinitely close to the line and falling ever more infinitely negative. But it is approaching negative infinity from the left and the right. So we can say that the two-sided limit is negative infinity, but by stating that, we are really stating that there is no real limit. There is no concrete y value, fixed y value that the graph approaches from both sides to have that two-sided limit exist. But I'm going to go ahead and, you know, we're going to use it. So as x approaches negative 1, the function is going to negative infinity. That's going to be a vertical asymptote. And we'll fill it in later because there's more information up here. Let's see here. The function at, now this isn't a limit statement, the function at 2 is equal to 1. So there's a point that exists of 2 comma 1. So over 2 and up 1. The limit as x approaches 5, now I have an exponent, if you will, a little notation of a negative. So we're going to be approaching the, 5 from the left, and the function as you approach 5 from the left goes up to positive infinity. And as you approach 5 from the right, the function goes down to negative infinity. So we're looking at, with these limits being positive and negative infinity, again, we're looking at a vertical asymptote. So we're going to have an x value 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I could have just said that there's a horizontal asymptote of y equals negative 2, but we are going to be talking about how you know, if you have the function approaching a y value as x approaches positive infinity and negative infinity, it doesn't always have to be the same actual value when you go to the negative, as you let x approach negative infinity and positive infinity. You can have a function have more than one horizontal asymptote. A lot of your, you know, some irrational functions have more than one horizontal asymptote. So I basically have limit notation here stating that we have a horizontal asymptote of, like I said, y equals negative 2. As x approaches positive infinity, if you haven't studied infinite limits again yet or studied horizontal asymptotes of rational functions, then this might be a little bit out of place, but it's coming up soon. The function is settling down and approaching a y value of negative 2, and the limit as x approaches negative infinity of f of x is, again, as you go to the left forever, it approaches negative 2. So we have a horizontal asymptote at y equals negative 2. Now remember, we're graphing, we're sketching possible functions, or we are sketching functions that have these, all of these properties. It doesn't necessarily mean we're drawing the answer. All right, so as x approaches negative 1 from the left and right, the function goes to negative infinity. So here's negative 1, and the function is approaching negative infinity. And it's not, you don't pull it away from the line, and don't make it look like it's becoming the line. Okay. Now, graphs actually can cross a horizontal asymptote. They can even oscillate around horizontal asymptotes. This function might come above the horizontal line of y equals 2 and then settle back down as you approach, as you let x approach negative infinity. But just to keep this simple, I'm going to keep this below the horizontal asymptote. Alright, so we have, we're approaching that value of 2 as x goes to negative infinity. As we approach negative 1 from the left, we go to negative infinity. And from the right, we have a function that exists, or a value that does exist at f of 2 is equal to 1. So, looks like maybe it's doing something like this, or a possible solution would be doing something like this. And as, you know, a lot of times when you have two vertical asymptotes, the function, you know, rises and falls through a point. But this one says, as you approach 5 from the left, the function is going to positive infinity. So as you approach 5 from the left, we're going out to positive infinity. Don't forget the arrows at the end of your graphs. And what else is left? As, let's see here, as x approaches 5 from the right, you're going to negative infinity. So 5 from the right, negative infinity. And as x approaches positive infinity, again, it's settling down at that same horizontal asymptote of y equals negative 2. So this is a possible, well, it's a sketch of a function that has all of these properties. We can maybe come up with other ones, but this is one that satisfies the question. One more example. Bam! The limit as x approaches 2 from the left is equal to negative 3. So we have that concrete limit, a real limit, as the function approaches negative 3. All right. So let's see here. Approaching 2 from the left. Approaching a y value of negative 3. So 1, 2, 3. All right. So about right there. And I didn't give anything about domain and range here. Just all I have to do is satisfy these limit statements. So the function, again, approaching 2 from the left, approaches the y value of negative 3, so could look like this. It could look like this. It could look like this. As long as it approaches the value, the x value of 2 from the left and ends up at the y value of 3, we're good. So now I got a bunch of stuff I have to erase. Let's do this. All right. At f of 2, it's equal to 0. And now, let me stop here. I should have, I did include it. Draw a sketch of the function. Function. Well, I have a closed dot here, which, you know, really is correct. I mean, I have a, at least with this covered, I have a line approaching, my graph approaching the positive 2 from the left, and, you know, this does have a limit of negative 3. But when I then have another point that's defined as 2, 0, and I have a basically a point here at 2, negative 3, I have a relation. This would fail the vertical line test. So I need to make that an open dot. And yet that function still has a limit of negative 3 as I approach 2 from the left. And the limit as I approach 2 from the right is equal to positive 2. So as I approach 2 from the right, my y value is approaching a value of 2. I have to leave it open again because I want to pass that vertical line test and actually have this be a function. And again, there's nothing about domain or range in the statement, so I can draw my function any way I like. Draw a straight line. As long as it's approaching 2 from the right and has a limit of positive 2. And that's in my last example. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.